He wrote The Art of the Deal. Now he's offering a deal to make America great again. That's what Trump's campaign is all about. And the crowds love it.
The American dream is dead, but I'm going to make it bigger and stronger and better than ever before. Right? Right?
That's something Trump says Jeb won't do.
I watch Jeb Bush. I think it's pathetic what's going on. His stance on Common Core. He's in favor of Washington educating your children. His weak stance on immigration. He said it's an act of love. I mean, what kind of stuff is that? That's baby stuff.
And Trump's no baby. He built a billion-dollar empire in real estate because, he says, he's got the art of the deal down pat. He cuts and shuffles, and when the heat is on, Trump plays to win.
Are you considering at all, since you're getting heat from every single direction, is there any chance you'll get out of the race with this?
No, I love it. I'm bringing to fore and getting a lot of credit for it, lots of different elements that are very important. We have incompetent leadership. We have leaders that don't know anything about negotiating. We're getting killed by China. We're getting killed by Mexico. We are a bunch of very, very foolishly led people.
Trump's right. Incompetent leadership. That's why Americans have dropped out of politics, not out of apathy, but out of disgust. Trump wants to change that.
I tell about the bad deals that this country's making. Mexico, I respect the country. They're taking our jobs. They're taking our manufacturing. They're taking our money. They're taking everything, and they're killing us on the border. And Mexico does not like it. So remember this. Don't worry, we'll take our country back very soon.
And Trump's all about USA, USA, USA. He's an American exceptionalist. He wants to make America great again, but with the Pentagon at the center.
Our military has to be strengthened. We've never been in trouble like this. The world hates us.
But Donald, it's because our weak military has wrought so much destruction around the globe that the world hates us. The world hates Israel too. But not Trump.
My name is Donald Trump, and I'm a big fan of Israel. And frankly, a strong prime minister is a strong Israel. And you truly have a great prime minister. In Benjamin Netanyahu, there's nobody like him.
And there's nobody who could win an election if Jews aren't swayed. Enter Trump's daughter, Ivanka, who's married to Jewish real estate mogul Jared Kushner, who's got startup investments in Israel. No penny ante marriage here. Ivanka married into the mega billionaire Kushner family, who stamps a Jewish imprint on New Jersey politics. She converted to Judaism, and Trump's grandkids are Jews. They all keep kosher. Doesn't stop there. Trump's son Eric is married to Inside Edition's Jewish TV producer, Laurie Anaska. Their kosher marriage was sealed under a crystal chuppah. And Trump's got a chuppah portfolio with millions invested in those tech startups in Israel. That's a special bond that can serve him well. For once his anti-immigration and lousy leaders plays out, he'll have to reach into his deck of cards. He's got a Trump card sure to please the Jews. A joker writ large with, "I'm a big fan of Israel." Without it, even Trump folds up.